What's going on, everybody? It's Simon, and what a difference a week makes. Three back-to-back away victories for Manchester United. I mean, after not winning away from home for months and months and months and months, three come along all at once. And off the back of that positive away performance against Chelsea in midweek and Ole Gunnar Solskjaer making Frank Lampard his bitch, United are back in action tomorrow, lunchtime, away again. This time down on the south coast as we go to take on Eddie Howe's Bournemouth side. And it's a game that I think about a week or so ago before these away wins, I think we'd all been looking out with a bit of trepidation, a bit of a worrying about it a little bit, if we could actually break this Bournemouth side down. But we've seen over the last week enough, I think, for a lot of United fans and United players themselves to be a little bit more confident heading in tomorrow, into tomorrow's game. Coming out of that game against Chelsea, some of the things that I was really pleased to see was Scott McTominay's leadership. We've seen him grow this season from game to game. He's been one of the standout players. If you're giving me a choice for player of the year right now, it's Scott McTominay ahead of pretty much everybody else pretty comfortably. He's been phenomenal, especially the last couple of weeks where he's really sort of grown into that role in midfield. And one thing what I didn't think was in Scott McTominay was the leadership, like I said, that he's shown in these last couple of games. You just look at the clips on Twitter about him in the 92nd minute against Chelsea, absolutely bollocking some of the more experienced players. He was bollocking our actual captain in Ashley Young to get in position in the 92nd minute, keeping those standards at United extremely high. And that's something we've been lacking for ages and ages and ages, ever probably since the days of the likes of Nemanja Vidic, certainly since the likes of Roy Keane. So it's really good to see the sort of player that Scott McTominay is starting to develop into, because if he keeps this going, he's going to cement that place in the middle of United's midfield, regardless of if we go and make signings in that area. So full props to Scott McTominay, and hopefully he has another standout performance against Bournemouth at the weekend. Now, Ollie's been talking to the press ahead of that game against Bournemouth, so I'm going to bring you a couple of quotes that he's mentioned today in the press conference. And speaking of Scott McTominay, Solskjaer has been talking about Scott in his press conference ahead of that game against Bournemouth. Ollie said that Scott is a leader, a United boy. You can see he's been a striker with the goal against Norwich on the half turn, but he's also developing into a very good midfielder. He's been excellent, and now that him and Fred work in a good partnership, they did it last season against PSG when we had a few injuries, and now as well, they are working well as a pair. And I fully agree with what Ollie's saying there. I mean, like I say, I've just waxed lyrical about Scott McTominay's performances. But like I say, I do agree with Ollie that there is some sort of a little bit of a partnership with him and Fred. We did see it last season in that game against PSG and a couple of games around it as well, which we tend to forget. But we've seen it especially blossom in recent weeks. Now, obviously, when Paul Pogba's fit, he's going to come straight back into that midfield. But it's good to see that Fred and McTominay can form some sort of little partnership when I think a couple of us, at least a couple of us, a couple of weeks ago, were probably fretting that this midfield is not good enough, which I don't think it's good enough to compete against the elite right now, but it's certainly developing. Ollie's also been talking about the general sort of mood, the general sort of development of his team. He's saying that the confidence is getting better. Players are coming back from injury, which obviously helps. All put together, in football, it's not very far from failure to success or the other way round, which he's pretty much alluding to the fact that it's been pretty close in a lot of games this season. Even the ones we've struggled in. You think of the likes of Wolves, Southampton, Crystal Palace. All of those teams really scored with their only opportunities on goal, where United struggled to put away chance after chance after chance. And it's slender margins that I think a lot of United fans were losing their shit about, but it was so slender that it was obvious that we weren't getting dominated in any sort of way in those games. We were the dominating side. It's just that we didn't take our chances, and when you don't take your chances, you always give your opposition half a chance, and that's exactly what they had, and they went up the other end and took them. So I agree with Ollie that it's there's a fine line between success and failure that United have pretty much been on all season, which is a little bit alarming. But he's also had a little bit of team news as well, Ollie, in that press conference, saying that he doesn't know whether the likes of Rashford, Maguire or Lindelof, who all came off all right with that game against Chelsea with a little bit of a knock, either be it a niggle or a fully-fledged knock, that he's not sure if they're going to be available for tomorrow. Obviously, there's another training session still left before that game against Bournemouth. So it remains to be seen whether those three are fit enough to make the trip down to the south coast. He's definitely ruled out the likes of Axel Tuanzebe, Nemanja Matic and Luke Shaw, ruling them all out until after the next Poxy international break, which comes in a couple of weeks' time, I think. So that's a little bit unfortunate that we're not getting those sorts of players back. Well, mainly Axel, if I'm being perfectly honest. I think the other two we can pretty much deal with. Don't expect to see either any of those three heading into this game against Bournemouth, who they're in a little bit of a poor run of form at the moment, Bournemouth. They're in ninth place in the Premier League, which is a couple of places below us, which is a rarity for us when heading into the game this season. But they're without a win in their last five. They've not scored a goal in their last three. They usually set up in a 4-4-2 formation. Obviously, as Ollie alluded to in his press conference, that they have got that quick, pacey forward line of Wilson, Josh King, Dominic Solanke and Ryan Fraser, all blessed with a lot of pace. We've also got to watch out for Harry Wilson as well, obviously unknown from Liverpool. We saw what he can do last season for Derby as they knocked the Carabao Cup. So we've got to keep an eye on him. But what they do try to do is they try to play football on the deck, Bournemouth. They do try to play this silky, attractive brand of football, regardless of who they're coming up against. They don't really tend to sit deep in a low block, which I think plays into United's hands a little bit. So we've got to exploit the gap in that 4-4-2, which tends to be between the defence and the midfield for Bournemouth. So hopefully we can pick those spaces up and hopefully we can exploit them and come away with another win, because four wins out of four would be away from home would be a fantastic turnaround in form for Ole Gunnar Solskjaer and Manchester United. So this is the United side I want to see line up against Bournemouth tomorrow lunchtime. So I've gone with David De Gea in goal, obviously returning from his absence in midweek where Romero played. I've got us reverting back to a back four, so I've gone with Wan-Bissaka. I'm guessing Lindelof and Maguire are going to be fit, but if Rojo has to come in for one of them, so be it. I think he performed very well against Chelsea in midweek, so I have no qualms with chucking Rojo in, although I think we need a little bit more quality on the ball from the back, and Lindelof and Maguire do bring that. I've also gone with Brandon Williams at left back now. I know the chances of that are probably very slim, having played 90 minutes against Chelsea. The chances are Ashley Young's going to come back in, but I think Brandon Williams has done more than enough to get that first game, that first start in the Premier League. And after all, Ashley Young can play in midweek against Partizan, because let's face it, we should be able to roll out our under-12s and get a decent result against them. So I've gone with Williams starting at left-back for United. Then I've gone with that midfield of McTominay and Fred, because I just don't think there's any other option. There's Jimmy Garner, but I think he's going to feature in midweek against Partizan. So I've gone with those two as the holding midfielders. Now, ahead of them, and I might cop a bit of flack, I've gone with Juan Mata. Arguments can be used for bringing Pereira in, who's, I think, had a very good couple of games. That's coming from a person who just was slagging him off a couple of weeks ago. I think he's really started to pick the right decisions, which was my main qualm with Pereira. But I think Juan Mata, in between that midfield and that defence, I think can pick those spaces up. And I think he's got the quality on the ball to hurt Bournemouth, who I don't think we're going to need that much pace in the middle, at least when we've got those pacey front three, which we're going to get onto now in James, Martial and Rashford. But to get those three involved, I've gone with Juan Mata, just for his quality on the ball, which hasn't been there this season, but we know he can do it in the past. So given our resources in that number 10 role, I've gone with Juan Mata, and hopefully he can provide the sort of quality that the pacey front three of James, Martial and Rashford can absolutely feed upon, because they've been hitting goals left and right in the last couple of weeks. Dan James has stood out so much with his improvement. Obviously, Martial and Rashford banging in the goals, so fair play to them. But Dan James, I didn't think he had it in his locker quite yet. But some of the quality of the balls that he's playing in now, he's developing into a really, really top-class footballer for Manchester United. And that front three is enough to give any sort of team trouble. So that's the side I've gone with. And like I say, heading into this game a couple of weeks ago, you'd have been back in a draw or hoping to come away with a draw. But now you've got to be looking at a win. Given the form that Bournemouth are in and the form that United are now in, with one loss, I think it is, in seven games, which nobody seems to be mentioning that. But heading into this game, I think we'll be looking at coming away with a win against Bournemouth. I think they're a team that are there for United to beat if we perform. So I'm going to go with a 2-0 United win. Obviously, they're not scored in three games, so if United can keep it tight at the back, I think we can come away with another clean sheet, which we've not really come away with that many of them this season. And I fancy United to get a couple of goals as well. So I've gone with 2-0 United to make it four wins out of four away from home. Who'd have thought that a couple of weeks ago? You'd have been locking me up in a nut house for suggesting that. But that's the sort of form we're in at the minute, and those are the sort of fine margins that are coming up for United this season. But let me know in the comment section what starting 11 you go with, and let me know what you think the score prediction is going to be as well. But if you've enjoyed this, bang a like on the video, hit that subscribe button. I'll be back with my reactions after the game tomorrow lunchtime, so keep it locked to the channel, and I'll catch you guys next time.